gonna take a minute, sugar.
I hope so.
Here, boy.
Hey, boy.
Daddy!
Well, surprise, we got a warm front passing through eastern Georgia this afternoon. Temperatures up a little on the average for this time of year. We're cooling towards...
Kimberly!
Kimberly?
What is it, baby?
Oh. You're dead.
What?
Mama and Daddy... And Bobby, someone shot him. Bobby, too.
Did you call the sheriff? I don't call the sheriff. I'll call the dispatcher and get him to call Walker and get him home.
What?
Someone take care of those dogs. There's a kennel in the back.
Kid says there's three down that he saw.
Walk around?
No. My guess is he's out on the road.
All right, let's go. Come on, boys! George, take the back.
Let's go.
Frank, check that side.
All right, over here.
How's it hanging, boy?
You gotta come home. There's some trouble at your parents' place.
What kind of trouble? What's going on, Clyde?
I don't know anything about it, Walker. Honest. The sheriff's there, and we want you back.
Okay, you tell him I'm 3 hours away. Out.
Walker,
Luke, do you have any idea who might have done this?
No, sir.
Do you think they could come back? I mean, if somebody's killing Morrison's, maybe we're next.
I don't know.
Where's Walker at?
He's on his way. He would have killed Luke, too, if he'd been home. Who could have done this?
Daddy, he had his enemies, you know. It could have been another trucking outfit, or...
Were there any drivers your daddy had a fight with?
I don't know.
Do you ever hear anyone threaten your daddy?
Nobody who...
That'll calm you. Help you sleep.
Well, we believe they were killed the night before you found them. Now, do you remember seeing any strange cars parked out on the road?
I've been at Kimberly's. I hadn't been home in a couple of days.
Couldn't we do this in the morning, George? Come on.
Yeah, I should get back to the house.
Slow down, Walker. Slow down.
What's going on,
Walker,
George?
You can't go in right
Where's
now.
Where's my mama?
You can't go in right now. I'm sorry.
Mama! Daddy!
Can't go in.
Walker, something terrible's happened. Your mom and daddy are dead. Young Bobby, too. Someone shot him.
No.
I'm real sorry, Walker.
I want to see him right now.
Not right George. Now. Look, we're gathering evidence.
What about Luke? Where's Luke?
Luke's the one who found him, Walker. He's over at your place. Why don't you go see him? He needs you.
You go to sleep now, sweet pea.
Mama, what's wrong with Uncle Luke?
Never mind that now, okay? We'll talk about it in the morning. Why don't you go climb in bed?
Okay.
Go on.
I was at Kimberly's when it happened. I came home to check in for her. I went out on my run. I just wish I could have been there, you know, because then I could.
You could have been killed yourself, Luke. I'm here now. We're gonna find out who did this. You just get some sleep. Come on. We'll talk tomorrow. Lay down. Come. You just rest.
So, looks like they must have shot Garth dead in the hallway, then continued on to Bobby's room, shot him. Then on into the parents' bedroom, they shot Flo, wounding her first. She must have tried to use the telephone. We found her bloody prints on it.
The killer, or killers, knew what they were doing. No spent shells, no fingerprints, no signs of forced entry. Nothing seems to be missing from the house, so we can rule out robbery. We need some theories, boys.
Well, you know how old Garth was. It wasn't love that built Morrison Trucking.
Yeah. I think it was someone they knew. A stranger never could have got past those dogs without waking everybody up.
Yeah, but who could have got past the dogs?
Well, a couple of the neighbors, cleaning lady, Luke.
And Walker.
When did you meet him by?
Why don't you try to eat something, Luke?
It's funny.
Okay.
Just the other day, Daddy's talking about how he's gonna take us up that rodeo up in Stanton.
Sure thing.
I still can't believe he's gone.
That was the funeral home. Somebody has to pick out some clothes for them all to wear.
You're more familiar with where the things are, Luke.
I can't. I don't ever want to go in that house again.
You can stay here as long as you want, right, hon?
Of course you can. You can have the room in the basement. You can have it as long as you need it. I'll get Aunt Claire to pick out some clothes.
Morning, Patty.
Morning, Byron.
Walker. How you holding up? Lousy timing on my part, but I have some questions for you.
Well, come on in, Byron.
Well, might be best if you come down to the office.
Okay, I'll get my keys.
You know what? Why don't you just ride with me? We can talk on the way.
What's going on?
It was just routine, Patty. We have a lot of blanks to fill.
I don't think my brother had anything to do with this, do you, Byron?
It's okay. I'll be back in a little while.
If you were upstate at the time of the murders, show us a gas receipt.
I already told you, Byron. I refueled up before I left.
What about a receipt from a diner?
Patty packed my meals.
You didn't check in with anyone when you picked up your load?
No. They left it for me in a lot. Why do you think I'd kill my family, Byron?
Morrison Trucking be yours. Your daddy leaned on you all your life, Walker. We all know that. We all understand why he'd want to put a stop to it.
Look at this road grind. I got dirt on my truck.
This company's going to hell in a handcart. You don't even make a decent trucker.
You know what? You do it. I'll go work for somebody else.
You know, you still ain't too big to take a hog strap to.
Yes, I am, Daddy.
You walk out of here now, that's it. You get nothing, you leave now. You go now. This is it. Nothing.
You're right. My daddy did lean on me all my life. Byron, you know what? I could take it. After I went back to working for him last year, things were good between us. He lost that mean streak, and now he's gone.
Uh-huh. You're free to go, Walker.
You've had him in there for 6 hours. A man who just lost most of his family? For someone who's supposed to know people, Byron, you sure missed on this one.
I'll be checking out your alibi, Walker. And I think it's best if another driver makes your out-of-state runs.
I'll find out who killed my family, Byron.
Looks like someone left Mama's nightlight on. Spooky's like someone's still in there. You guys been inside?
No. I can't face it. We'll get someone to go in and clean up after Byron says it's all right.
You know, here's Billy Tedhauser. He had it in for Daddy.
What was that trouble?
Oh, Daddy caught him switching some old tires for some new ones, and he fired him. Billy said he'd kill him. I don't think he'd have it in him.
But if they hated Garth, why kill Flo and Bobby?
So there wouldn't be any witnesses. Luke, how you doing? You got anything over there?
No. I've been looking till my head hurts. This whole thing's been really hard on Kimberly, too. I should really go see how she's doing tonight.
It'd be nice if we could all stay together as family for a while.
It's okay, Luke. Go ahead. Just don't forget you got that big fern necker load. You got to take up to Toronto on Thursday.
Can Willie take it? I don't feel up to it, man.
Well, okay. It's going to take both of us to look after things. I mean, that's what Daddy would say if he is here, business first. You know, doesn't matter what's happened. We got a top 300,000 this year, you know?
Yeah. That's what you say.
Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servants, Bobby Joe, Rita Florence, and William Dark. Receive them into your mercy, into blessed rest and everlasting peace. Grant them rest eternal, O Lord, and let light perpetually shine upon them.
Can I see Grandma and Granddaddy again?
No, honey. They've gone up to heaven. They're with angels now.
We commit their bodies to the ground and their souls to the glorious company of your angels.
Down on you. What do you think she'd say?
Hey, Walker. People are saying the sheriff's checking you out. What? You a murder, Walker?
Your beer. I'm sorry, Walker. You got nothing to be sorry about, Luke. We all gotta get through this in our own way. I just don't want you to hurt yourself.
You're a good brother. You're always looking out for me.
Come here.
No, 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 do that, Chief.
I love you.
So, you'll each be entitled to half of the company, all of its assets, and your parents' home and property. Walker, as the eldest, you'll become the executor of the estate. That means, Luke, that he'll hold your money in trust until you come of age at 21.
Okay. I just don't really make all that much money from driving. And Daddy always used to give me an allowance. I can't just get a little bit of that money, you know, to live on?
Well, there is something else. Your daddy had a life insurance policy. He named Luke and Bobby as beneficiaries, $200,000. Since Bobby's gone, it all goes to you, Luke.
Well, Jim, why Luke and Bobby only?
Well, it was when you had that falling out about 2 years ago and you went and drove for that other company for a while. Your daddy took your name right off his policy.
I remember that. Daddy said he's gonna take you off the will, too.
Yeah, he said he was writing up a new will, but he never submitted it to me.
Man, well, you know how Daddy was. He's one day he's mad at you, next day he's your best friend. He's probably all just talk. Boy, 200 grand. For real. I can certainly live on that.
Yeah, we found the UPS guy that had delivered a package of flower seeds sometime between the murders and when the bodies were found.
Yeah?
He didn't see anything.
Byron, the new forensics. They found blood traces in the basement. The killer went to the basement after the murders.
Yeah? Why would he do that?
Steal something? Hide something?
Get Charlie D in here. I'll be back in an hour.
Well, where are you going, Byron?
I think I'll go fishing.
Hey, look who's here.
I wonder what he wants. Hey, Byron.
Boys.
Any news?
Nothing yet. We checked the list of names you gave us. You know, we're checking out some leads. Little like hunting rabbits. You got to eliminate every bush till you find out where that rabbit is. Sooner or later, though, we'll get a break. Right now, the polygraph man is down from Atlanta. He wants to test everyone connected with the case. I'd appreciate it if the two of you would come in.
Both of us?
Yeah, they want to do everyone.
Well, I got to service a truck for that Stevenson load up to Kansas City this afternoon. I could maybe do it sometime next week.
No, this is more important. Let's cooperate. Willie can take that load. Clear our names, he can get on with this investigation. Come on.
I'll meet you down there.
Is your wife's name Patty?
Yes.
Do you have green eyes?
Yes.
Is there any information you're hiding about the murders of your parents and brother?
No.
You know, I've been thinking about it, Byron. Daddy kept a lot of things from us, but he had these dealings with this Cincinnati company up in Chicago a while back. They were mafia. You know, he cut off business with them all of a sudden, and you know how stubborn Daddy can be sometimes. I get the feeling that this whole thing is a mafia hit. You know?
Whenever you're ready.
I mean, y'all should check that out.
We're ready. Just relax, Lou. This will only take a minute.
You wearing a black t-shirt?
Yes, sir.
Did you drive here today?
Yes.
Do you know who murdered your parents and brother?
No, sir, I wish I did.
Just answer yes or no.
Sorry.
How'd it go?
It's good. Great. It's weird, though. I mean, you get hooked up to that machine. I swear, it doesn't matter if you're innocent. You just start to feel all nervous.
Well, thanks for coming in, boys. I'll keep you informed about the investigation.
Byron, take a look at this. Here. There.
Oh, no.
Mm-hmm. I do.
my boots.
It suits you.
And you get.
May I help you, son?
Well,
sir,
I believe I'm gonna have to buy this car.
Well, let me say that you have made a fine choice and that you're a lucky man, because on this little sweetheart, I could offer you reasonable monthly payments.
Well, I was thinking, actually, that I don't really want to make monthly payments.
Well, how are you supposed to pay for this, son?
Y'all do accept cash, don't you?
I always want to do that.
How long has your daughter been dating Luke?
About a good 9 months by now.
It's a terrible shock to think something like this could happen. Kimmy will tell you it's almost destroyed the boy.
Do you have any suspects, Sheriff?
No one we can talk about yet, Mr. Granger. Now, on that night, Luke slept here?
Yes, that's right. He did that from time to time, down here on the couch.
Kimmy, of course, was upstairs in her room with the door closed.
Yes, but are you sure he was here all night?
You're not thinking of Luke.
Oh, ma'am, it's just routine. We have to eliminate everyone.
See, there's one thing that I don't understand. How is it you can be sure that he was here all night? You were asleep.
I got up a couple times.
He's up every 2 hours with his kidneys.
I checked on Luke every time, and the boy was on the couch.
Miss Granger, is it possible that he might have gone out for a couple hours and you didn't know?
I'd have heard him. I'd have known. Sheriff, I had a beautiful young daughter upstairs and a healthy young buck downstairs. Believe me, I'd have known if he'd have set 1 foot off this couch. I'm telling you, the boy was here on the couch all night long.
Well, it'd be 50 minutes each way at the speed limit.
Yeah, it's a speed limit. Last thing the boy'd want is for a trooper to pull him over. Mm-hmm. How long you figure in the house?
20 minutes, 15 at the least. So he'd have to be gone 2 hours. We should go back and time Granger's kidneys.
Yeah. All right, let's walk this thing through again. Patty, Walker.
What brings y'all out here?
Well, we were having another look through the house.
Yeah? Well, then what? Did you find something?
First piece of hard evidence. We found it in Bobby's room, between mattress and headboard.
Well, that's great. Can you connect it to the killer?
It's a 16 gauge. We're going to put it through ballistics, comparing it to a short barrel Remington, one of the guns in the basement.
Walker, do you know the last time that gun was used?
No, I don't.
It was cleaned recently. We believe that the killer was very familiar with the house. Now, if it is the murder weapon, the killer found the cleaning materials, cleaned the weapon, and put everything back in its place. There's something else I should tell you. Luke failed the polygraph. He's now our prime suspect.
What? You must be crazy, Calhoun.
Hey, Byron. How's the investigation going?
Getting real close, Luke. Real close. Be in touch.
Uncle Luke! Uncle Luke!
Man, I am in love.
Our little sweetheart's got 350 cubic inches, 325 horse. Pure power. You want to take her out?
Yeah, not right now, Luke.
What old Byron had to say?
He found a shell casing in Bobby's room. 16 gauge. Says it's a real good lead.
Yeah? All right. That's good. It's about time he did something, huh?
Well, that is a beautiful necklace.
Isn't that nice? Luke bought it for me. You're such a sweet thing. It's real, 18 karat gold. And a diamond watch, too. It's Swiss. Luke's got one, too.
Well, you're just all set now, aren't you?
Who wants to make some lemonade?
Me, I do!
Oh, yeah? I bet you I beat you there.
That 16 gauge is Luke's gun, isn't it?
Oh, but you believe Luke killed Mama, Daddy, and Bobby?
I don't know. But I think it's not impossible.
Hey, that's the craziest thing I ever heard. That test don't mean nothing. Byron went after me, now he's going after Luke. He's running around in damn circles.
Did you hear what he was saying? It was someone who knew the house, knew the gun.
I don't want to hear any more about that. That's enough.
Yes. The property is gorgeous. I have several buyers up in Atlanta who I know will be interested in a property like this. We should have no trouble at all.
Daddy was so proud of this big house. Lots of good memories for me growing up here.
Three bedrooms, is that right?
Mm-hmm. Two little ones upstairs.
The master bath is nice and big. There's room for a jacuzzi.
Nothing's changed. I almost think it never happened. Daddy cleared this land and built this house brick by brick, all by himself. It's a family home, and I don't think I can sell it. Truth is, the thing that makes me happy is to move back in here.
You want to live here?
We could do it. I mean, we could sell the house in town. Got the office and the sheds right here. We got the woods and the fields. I mean, this is where the kids should grow up. They'd love it here.
I don't know if it's such a good thing to do.
Maybe it's the best thing to do. It's a way to face up to what's happened here. Put it all behind us.
I don't know if I can.
Well, Patty, I really think that we could be happy out here. I mean, it's what my mom and daddy would have wanted. Can we just give it a try?
What on earth would possess y'all to move in that house?
Well, it's the practical thing to do, Luke. Why don't you think about moving back in your old room?
Luke couldn't live in that house after what he saw. Surprised you can't.
I don't even want to go in that house, let alone live there. Y'all knew that.
Luke, anyway, you got a room there. Anytime you want it, change your mind.
Hi, Patty.
Byron.
Let me give you a hand.
Thank you.
Another gorgeous day. Sure could use some rain, though.
Byron, you didn't come find me to talk about weather.
I just went by the house, but I guess Walker's out on the run. It's been confirmed, Patty. The murder weapon was a 16-gauge from the basement. That's Luke's gun, isn't it?
I don't know. I guess he used it sometimes.
What'd Luke say when he found out we had the shell?
He didn't say much. Said it was good.
Good? What about Walker? He give any more thought to what we told him?
You're gonna have to ask him.
Isn't that Luke's stuff?
Yeah, I'm gonna send it on over to him.
Well, hold on. I've been talking to him. Maybe he's gonna change his mind.
Walker, I don't want Luke living with us. I don't even want Luke around after what I've been told.
After you've been told what? What are you talking about?
The lab confirmed it was Luke's shotgun that killed your folks.
Who told you that?
Byron.
Byron told you that? What's Byron talking to you for? That son of a...
How you guys doing? You miss your Uncle Luke?
Yeah.
Yeah? I got something for you. Another housewarming gift.
Well, that's really nice, Luke. You didn't have to do that.
Hey, no problem.
Can we tell him now?
I've asked Kimberly to be my wife.
You actually want to marry this no-good pea picker?
You know I do.
Well, I'm happy for y'all. Lord knows we can use some happiness in this family. Yeah. When's the big day?
Can we come?
Sure you can, baby doll. Planning to do it the Saturday after next.
So soon?
I don't see no reason to wait. Do you, sugar?
Walker, I'd, appreciate it if you'd be my best man.
Well, it'd be an honor. Daddy wanted you to take that money, go to college, make a better life for yourself.
I got a good life, bro. I got money. I'm marrying the most beautiful girl in the county.
Well, how much of the money from Daddy's insurance you got left now?
That's my affair.
Well, he'd have gone crazy to see how you're spending it.
Well, Daddy's not around anymore, is he?
Well, you're marrying Kimberly. Look, I'm not saying nothing against it. All right, if you're happy, Luke. But you know what Mama would have said, Kim, a Methodist and all.
Man, I swear you were sounding more and more like Daddy every day. You know that? I mean, you're not a quarter as bad as he is yet, but you're headed in that direction. And I'm not a kid, Walker. I'm not asking for your permission.
Luke, I just want you to be happy. That's all.
Kimberly, do you think this is such a good idea so soon after the murders?
Getting married? Luke seems to think it's a good idea.
Well, I mean, with the case still open. You know they're investigating Luke. Everybody knows that's ridiculous. But are you sure you want to marry him before he's cleared of the crime? Of course I am. Life has to go on. That's what Luke says, and I agree with him. I think it's a good idea.
Luke, before we go back in, I gotta talk to you about something. Byron told me you failed your polygraph test. I know it's stupid and things are all screwed up. It's that Byron. He had it out for me, now he's got it in his head. It's you, and I just want you to clear your name
All right, so he can get on looking for the real killer. Now, I checked it out. You can go to Atlanta, and they can give you a more complete test.
I won't go to Atlanta.
I know you don't want to go to Atlanta, but I'm going to take care of the expenses on this one.
Oh, it's a waste of time and money, and it's not going to mean a thing. I'm innocent. I don't give a damn if some sheriff don't believe that.
Do it for me. All right, we don't even got to tell Byron. Just take that test for me.
I can do it for you. It hurts me that you'd even ask. I'm not going, and that's it.
Luke, I tell you what I'm going to do. You go to Atlanta, and I'm going to sell one of the trucks and give you the cash as a wedding present, okay?
I don't give a damn about your money. What, the truck's mine anyway. Whole damn company's mine if I ever find that will.
Hey, Luke, you don't do this one thing for me, then I'm sorry. I don't think I can be your best man at your wedding.
Is anxious to get started.
He ain't coming, Aunt Claire. Said he wouldn't, and he's not.
I can't believe he'd miss his own brother's wedding. What is going on between you two?
You best ask him. He's so damn stubborn. Let's start.
Uncle Luke caught the biggest catfish in the whole pond. And you know what? Yes, he did. You know what I did? I grabbed on to him. Yes, sir. And he grabbed on to me, and we grabbed on that big old tree by the pond, and we pulled that fish to the shore.
No, you didn't.
Yes, we did.
You did.
And then you know what else happened? Mama cooked it up, and we fed half the county, and...
No, you didn't.
Yes, we did. Still had some for breakfast, didn't we, Mama?
No, you
don't. Okay, come on. Time for bed.
You think they're married yet?
Well, I don't know, buddy. I feel bad we couldn't go, too. Sometimes grown-ups just disagree on things.
All right, you two, come on. It's time to brush your teeth.
I want to suck your blood.
Yeah.
Good night.
Oh, you're getting big.
Walker! You ruined the most important day of my life.
You keep your voice down.
Everyone's coming into the church all asking me, where's Walker? What am I supposed to tell them?
Well, Luke, you made your decision. I made mine.
They're all starting to think you're against me.
Oh, Luke, your brother's not against you.
Oh, well, someone around here is. You? You and your little friend, the sheriff? Tell me something, Patty. Do you think that it was right that my brother never came to my wedding? Sure you do. Walker can do no wrong. You know who you remind me of? Mama. You can be just like her. Bobby this and Bobby that. Mama, her sweet little Bobby. Bobby could do no wrong either. Well, let me tell you something, sis. Walker, my brother. That's a bond that's stronger than any marriage. So don't you think that you can ever come between us? You understand?
Walker, you're supposed to be the head of the family now, and instead you're tearing it apart. I'll tell you, the rumors are flying. Some say it's money. Some say you just hate the Grangers. Others have it you're in love with Kimberly yourself.
Oh, come on.
As if this family hasn't had enough tragedy. Just what is going on between you two?
You don't know what's going on. Luke failed his polygraph test. Now Byron suspects him.
Of the murders?
I want him to go to Atlanta, take another test, clear his name. He won't do it. Refuses.
But you must know in your heart Luke had nothing to do with it.
I want some answers, Claire.
Yeah.
Hey, where are Beau and Michelle?
didn't the Uncle Luke pick them up at lunch? Well, I thought I saw that car of his.
Took him for a ride.
I'm
he loves those kids.
Byron.
Don't involve Byron.
Are you coming or not?
Patty.
How long they've been gone?
Just since noon. I'm sure everything's fine.
Yeah, they'll turn up. Best thing for you to do is go home. They might be there or they might call. George?
No, I would really like to go with you and look for him, please.
That's our job, Patty. You go home.
Come on. He's right. Let's go.
Michelle? Bo? Oh. Walker?
It's okay. We'll find them. We'll be all right. Come on.
Surprise!
Oh. Man, we got you so good. Party car in a shed so you couldn't see it.
Where were you, Luke, and what were you doing?
We were driving around in a car, seeing the sights. Is there something wrong?
Yeah, something's wrong. What were you thinking of? You didn't realize how upset we'd be?
No, I didn't. I'm sorry. I would have had him back sooner. It's just we were having too much damn fun, weren't we, guys?
Yeah!
I don't want you around my family anymore, Luke. You understand that?
I beg your pardon?
You stay away from us.
Patty.
Hold on, Walker. You don't want me around here anymore?
No.
Well, then, that's the way it's gonna be.
Patty. Honey. Luke's my brother, and I'll deal with him, okay?
Can't you see he's dangerous? He threatens me. He takes off with the kids. What does he have to do? Kill us all?
He listened to me. My brother loved my mama and daddy and Bobby. Now, you're asking me to believe that my little brother killed my whole family? I can't do that. I'm sorry.
Safe trip.
Okay.
What do you want?
Just thought I'd come over for a visit. Walker's gonna be gone till tomorrow morning. Thought we'd have some privacy.
I told you not to come around here.
Yeah, well, I think you and I got some things we need to talk about.
I have nothing to say to you.
Well, I do. I ain't leaving until we reach an understanding.
All right, then. I'm just gonna go inside and I'm gonna check on the kids. And then we can talk out here.
Patty, if you don't come back, we'll come in.
His car and tell him to get out to the Morrison place as quickly as he can. Thank you.
Why don't you come on over here and sit down?
What do you want to talk to me about?
You really think I killed my folks? Because if you do, that hurts me.
And you think that I went in there with my shotgun and I blew them all away. Bam, bam, bam. Mama and Daddy, sweet little Bobby. And then the other day, you thought I might even hurt your kids. Me. What kind of person you think I am? And now I can see that you're scared I might hurt you. My own sister-in-law. You're trying to turn my brother against me. Break up what's left of our family. You think I might hurt you. Well, that hurts me, Patty. When are you gonna stop hurting me?
Man, what'd you have to go and do that for? Sam's such a nice little chap.
What are you doing, Luke?
Just had a little visit with my sister.
Did you invite him?
No.
Did you ask him to leave?
Yeah.
Well, that sounds like a case of harassment to me. Get in the car. You can have a little visit with me.
I ain't going anywhere with you, Byron.
Is that a fact?
Uh-huh.
You got a choice, boy. You can get in that car by the time I count to three, or you're going to be picking gravel out of your backside for the next week. One way or another, we're going to have a little chat. One, two.
All right, Byron, I'll play your little game. I'll see you soon.
Get in the car. Okay, Luke. I want you to go through it again. I've got a few more questions.
Nothing to hide. Who's he?
I'm the man with the questions.
Where's my brother?
We're asking him some questions.
Well, let me talk to him, because this is gonna stop right now. Coming around scaring Patty.
Yeah, she's got good reason to be scared.
I don't want to get into that again, Byron. This is family business. Just let me take him home.
First, I want you to listen to something. Come on.
All right. Again, after you turn the corner.
I told you. I saw Daddy in the hall. I went up to him. I saw he was dead.
Then I went in Bobby's room. I saw Bobby on the bed. I went up to him, but I didn't touch him. I knew he was dead.
Who's he?
FBI Special Agent Fraser. Criminal psychologist.
I hate talking about this.
Did you go into the big bedroom?
I told you, no. I turned and ran. I don't remember much then.
All right. All right, what if I told you that
your prints are all over your mama's bedroom door?
Yes, so what? I lived there. I went in my mama's room all the time.
But on the day you discovered the murders, did you go into your mama's bedroom?
I don't remember. It all happened so fast.
It's not gonna cut it with us, Luke. You're gonna have to remember.
I want to remember. Don't you understand that?
Sit down.
Did you go into your mother's room?
Yeah, maybe I went in the room.
Yeah, you'd have to. You'd have to be right beside her. I mean, you told the sheriff that you looked right into your mama's eyes. You'd have to be standing right over her.
Now you eat up all of your French toast, Bobby, honey. I made it because it's your favorite.
Hey, where's my French toast?
Your lady, you can have cornflakes.
That ain't fair.
Hey, Mom! Luke! What have you done?
You don't give a damn about me.
Luke, did you kill your mother?
No, sir, I did not. I can never kill my mama.
It's just that
I have trouble remembering is all.
I blocked it all out, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember. I was inside the room.
Did you, see the name she wrote?
What name?
On the headboard. She wrote in her own blood before she died. What if I was to tell you that the name that she wrote was yours?
I guess that's because Mama loved me best.
I think you're lying to me now.
Mama never wrote no name on any bed. You guys are grasping at straws.
That means you ain't got nothing on me, isn't that right?
Walker?
Yeah?
I need your help.
Out of here this time. But just remember something, Luke. There's two people in this world knows who killed your family. I'm looking at one, and you're looking at the other.
What the hell are you doing?
Your daddy's will. What the hell do you think I'm doing?
Hey, Luke, you want the whole company, huh?
You want the trucks? You want everything? There's no will here.
I need money, Walker!
You had $200,000 and you blew it off. Stupidest thing I ever saw.
Yeah, you're talking like daddy again. I hate it when you do that.
Yeah, like you hated him, huh? Like you hated Mama and Bobby?
Oh, that's right. Now you're thinking about it, aren't you? You're wondering, did little Luke do it?
Did you do it, Luke?
Oh, what do you think? You think I did it?
I don't want any games, Luke.
It's just interesting to me to see the faith that my brother has in me.
Sheriff's been working on Patty. Patty's been working on you.
Get your hands off me! It's off of me! Walker, where? You're gonna come in that house, and you're going in those bedrooms, and you're gonna show me what you saw!
No, Walker, I ain't going in that house!
I'm not going in your house, Walker!
Show me! Tell me that you didn't do it!
Oh, God.
Did you do it?
You believe it, you won't believe, big brother. Do what you gotta do.
Stop, Walker! Don't, Walker, please don't do this, Walker. Just let him go. Let him go. Please.
You take two of the Max. That's your half. You send Willie or someone around tomorrow. Pick them up. I'll sign the papers. They'll be on the front seat. And I don't owe you anything. I never want to see you again. You understand?
Okay.
If you come back here, Luke, I'll kill you.
Byron, how you doing?
I thought you were up in Atlanta.
Yeah, we were, but we're back now. Staying up in the Winborn place. Saved my boy. Hey, cute little devil.
Yeah. Luckily, he got his looks from his mama. We got to straighten something out, Luke. It's all very well talking out here in the street like this, showing off your boy, but nothing's changed. Just so you don't misunderstand.
Hey, Byron.
Daddy said you might be here.
That's nice of you, Byron.
You know, my mama's over there by those trees. I even have a plot of my own. Like knowing where I'm gonna end up. I'm no rush, I understand, but my line of work, you never know. Saw a mutual acquaintance of ours in town yesterday. You know Luke's back?
Heard something about it.
He call you yet?
No, he won't.
I hear he's out of money. That's why he's come back. Sooner or later, he'll call you. I know who killed your family, Walker. Deep down, I think you do, too. Luke belongs in prison.
Nothing's gonna bring my family back.
No. But I think it's the only way your mama and daddy and Bobby can rest in peace.
Hey, pal.
Not in the room, buddy.
No, no.
Can't go in the room.
Lala. There's Mom over here. What you so worried about? Huh? Huh?
Hi. Look what you got here.
Just to Nassau. Just for a week. Mama said she can take care of the baby.
We can't afford it, Kimberly.
Why don't we sell the truck? It's not like it's making us some big income.
I tell you, two times I screw up, they blacklist me. I bet you it's because my brother's been bad-mouthing me to him, you know?
Luke, when we got married, you said you owned Morrison Truck, and that's what you said. I didn't know we were going to be having money problems.
Hello.
Walker. Phone.
Yeah.
Come on.
Hey, how's it going?
Hello, Luke.
What do you want?
I was just thinking about you is all. I mean, we haven't even talked to each other in 2 years. Just hoping there's, you know, some way we could
patch things up.
How's work? They gave me some loads?
You know they're not.
Stafford's nothing but a horse's ass. I heard you sold a truck.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had to. Other one's in tip-top shape, though. It's all ready to go.
Look, Walker.
Truth is, I won't come back. Work for you. I don't know, Luke. I think about that.
Yeah, well, of course.
You know, you think about it. I'll give you a call back in a couple of days. I appreciate it. Just, you tell Patty and the kids I said hi.
Okay.
What does he want?
Let's come back.
You're not gonna let him.
We've had 2 good years without him in our lives. If he comes back to work for the company, it'll be like it was before. But if you refuse him, it could be worse. Can't you just give him some money, make him go away? I don't want him back in our lives.
If I was to do this, how would it work?
Well, we'll put a mic on you. Then you invite him over for a visit. When the two of you are alone, you'll have to draw him out. Tell him you think that he was a victim. Let him know that you believe he was justified in doing what he did. Believe me, if there was any other way to find out the truth,
Well, what if he catches on?
You'll have to trust us, Patty. We'll have several agents near him and a sharpshooter on him at all times.
A sharpshooter?
Well, yeah, I see it. You got 2 choices. You can settle this thing now once and for all, or you can spend the rest of your life never knowing the truth.
Now, I want you to try and face him when he talks. Don't get too far away. How's that? Comfortable?
Mm-hmm. Just try and keep him around the office, trucks, and the tool shed. He should be well covered. Now, the DA's office has only given us 1 shot at this, so give it your best. Oh, you expecting the governor, Patty?
Cooking calms my nerves.
Listen, the kids are at your mom's. We got Walker well covered.
I've never seen him so nervous. He could just break down and Luke could do about anything out there.
Look, he'll be fine. You just serve up one of your famous dinners. And keep Kimberly out of the way.
Byron, you just get him through this alive.
Thank you.
My pie's good.
About the best darn lasagna I ever eaten, too.
Thanks, Luke. I knew it was your favorite.
What about mine?
What? Yours is good, honey. Mm-hmm. Yours is. That's yeah. Just that's about as close to paradise as a man could come. You know?
Hey, Walker, you hear old Jake Lomax died? It's a shame. He's a good old man.
Yeah, none better.
Didn't his granddaughter move to New York? Married that dentist.
I heard she was trying to be a singer in L.A.
Actually, that was her sister, Mary Beth.
That's right. People's lives are interesting. They sure are.
You know, we have a lot of pie left. Why don't y'all take some home?
Well, all right. Don't mind if I do take a slice or two.
It's gonna get dark soon.
Why don't we go take a look at that truck? See if she's in one piece.
Sure.
They're heading out. Now fall back.
Well, you know, I kept her up. Regular service. Look, you know, I feel bad about the way we fell out.
It's been 2 years, and I've been thinking,
maybe you're right. Maybe we should put the past behind us.
Well, yeah, well, the way I figure it, I can buy back into the company with the truck, help you run things, you know, the way you want. We can build this company up together. You know, I mean, that's what Daddy would have wanted. Oh, hell, I don't even care about that. I mean, I've been thinking, and in a strange way, we're better off without him. You really think that? Luke, all I'm worried about is what works for you and me.
Been thinking about putting some cows out here in this pasture.
You serious? What kind you figure on? Oh, I don't know. Maybe a Charolais. 100 head to start.
I'd be all right. We got ourselves a couple horses. We got roundups going on in the spring. Get rid of these damn trucks. We just become full-time cowboys. Yeah. Man, I forget how much fun we had.
We're gonna have ourselves a heap more fun. That's for sure.
Come on. Let's take a walk.
So I told her, you gotta be crazy hanging with that guy when he pulls those kind of things. Girl, you get out of that relationship. That's what I told her. Good for you, Kim. Hey, Kim, do you think maybe you could finish up for me here? Put away that crystal?
Pure?
I've got a little headache coming on. I'm gonna go take an aspirin.
What you saying earlier about us being better off without Daddy?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, I was just surprised is all. Because I always figured you took him for the cat's ass.
Well, Luke, I'll tell you, there was times he made me so mad that I felt like killing him right on the spot. Mama never loved us like she loved Bobby. You know? I tell you the truth, I don't miss any of them a whole hell of a lot. Bobby and Mama spouting that Bible trash all the time.
I hated going to church.
Look, I'm saying life goes on, Luke. Let's just go on with it, huh? Let me get that. Morrison Trucking.
Yeah, listen, Walker, you're doing
real good. He's starting to trust you.
Now, ask him some questions. Ask him about the shell we found.
Okay, sure.
Bring him along to where he's gonna be talking.
And then you be quiet, okay? We need a full confession.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah, you take care too.
Who's that?
Ray Spicer, Bath and Tires. I want to tell you, if you did do it, you were smart, man. I mean, you didn't leave that Byron anything.
Byron's a horse's ass. Couldn't solve a murder if his life depended on it.
Just that one shell. You know they matched with your gun, right?
I looked all over that dang thing.
I've been thinking about it, Luke, and ready to bring you in. 50-50. Full partner.
That's all I wanted. That's all I ever wanted. Just you and me.
I can't see him. It's no good. They're blocked.
Number two, find a position and take over.
Patty? What are you doing?
Grab her. Get
the hell are you doing? Luke!
Put her in the kids' room.
Well, the thing is, Luke, if we're gonna be partners, working together every day, I gotta know what happened that night. Everything. I mean, that's how partners have to be with one another.
What was that?
What?
That sound, I heard something.
I didn't hear anything, Luke.
I did. Why are you asking me about the killings? Why would Ray Spicer be calling about tires on a Sunday?
I don't know.
Working with Byron?
Hey, come on, put that gun down.
You wearing a wire or something?
I'm not wearing a wire. Put the gun down.
Prove it.
Hold steady.
Prove it, big brother. Strip.
What?
I'll see if you're wearing a wire. Take it off.
If he finds the mic, shoot him.
Come on.
I'll start for you, Luke.
I'm sorry, brother. I guess I'm just paranoid. I tried so hard to please Mama. I can never do anything right. Bobby can never do anything wrong. That day I'd gone to church with Mama and Bobby in the morning. And I left early. Daddy found out about it. He lost it. Told me I was grounded for the day. He took away my keys. Said I was gonna have to cut all the grass. I'd had it. I took one of Max and I headed on down to Kimberly's place. Went to sleep. Later on, about 2 a.m., everyone was sleeping.
I took their family car and I came back home. I came in through the kitchen doors, left them unlocked.
So you planned it, Luke?
Yeah, it's planned. I came in, I took the phone off the hook so I couldn't call out from the bedroom. I went downstairs to the basement, got my 16 gauge because I knew it wasn't going to jam. I decided I was going to do Bobby first.
Did Bobby wake up?
No. He never knew what hit him. Then I went in Mom and Daddy's room. I hit Mom first. But Daddy jumped up, started hollering at me. I got scared and I ran. But I realized that I was gonna have to finish what I started. I turned right around. Shot Daddy. Then I went on to Mama.
Mama knows you?
She looked me right in the eyes. She didn't say anything. She just sat there holding that Bible, as usual. I shot her 3 times. And I picked up all the shells. Daddy's always telling us we gotta pick up all the shells. Went down to the basement, I cleaned my gun, put it back on the rack. I got in the car, went on back to Kimberly's place. I passed out on the couch.
Are you sorry, Lou?
No. I'd do it all the same if I had a chance.
Hold steady. Stand by.
It's good being able to talk to you about this.
Get ready to move in, boys.
It feels real good to know that you understand. And now we can finally put this thing behind us. Move on.
Luke Jackson Morrison, you are under arrest for the murders of Garth Morrison, Florence Morrison, and Bobby Morrison. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
I didn't want it to be Luke. I didn't want it to be Luke.
I'm sorry. It's going to be okay.
Get him out of
here.
In the matter of the state of Georgia versus Luke Jackson Morrison, the prisoner will rise. Luke Jackson Morrison, this court has found you guilty of 3 counts of capital murder in violation of the criminal code and against the peace and dignity of the state of Georgia. In a premeditated act, you did brutally murder 3 members of your own family. Do you have anything you wish to say before sentence is passed?
Only that you don't prosecute my wife. She had nothing to do with it.
Now, son, I want to hear you tell me. Did you kill your daddy?
Yes, sir.
And while he was sleeping, did you kill your little brother, Bobby?
Yes, sir.
And, son, did you kill your good mama?
Yes, sir, I did.
Well, under these circumstances, this court sees fit to sentence you to death by electrocution on a future date yet to be determined. Order! Order in my court!
Your Honor, I'm Walker Morrison. May I speak?
Go ahead.
Luke is my last surviving brother. He's the last of my family. And we're all that's left. Now, it was me that got him to confess to this horrible thing that he did. But nobody said anything about killing him. There's been enough death in my family. Your Honor, I gave him to you. But if you sentence him to die, I'm gonna have the death of my little brother on my hands.
The court has heard you, Mr. Morrison. In the light of Mr. Walker Morrison's comments, the court has reconsidered sentence and now sentences Luke Jackson Morrison to 3 consecutive life terms for the murder of his mother, his father, and of his brother. There will be no possibility of parole. Court is adjourned. Officers, take away the convictions.
Let's walk this thing through again. Hey, Fatty. Walker.
What brings y'all out here?
Well, we were having another look through the house.
Yeah? Well, what, did you find something?
First piece of hard evidence. We found it in Bobby's room, between mattress and headboard.
Well, that's great. Can you connect it to the killer?
It's a 16 gauge. We're going to put it through ballistics, comparing it to a short barrel Remington, one of the guns in the basement.
Walker, do you know the last time that gun was used?
No, I don't.
It was cleaned recently. We believe that the killer was very familiar with the house. Now, if it is the murder weapon, the killer found the cleaning materials, cleaned the weapon, and put everything back in its place. There's something else I should tell you. Luke failed the polygraph. He's now our prime suspect.
What? You must be crazy, Calhoun.
Hey, Byron. How's the investigation going?
Get real close, Luke. Real close. Be in touch.
Uncle Luke! Uncle Luke!
Man, I am in love. That little sweetheart's got 350 cubic inches, 325 horse. Pure power. You want to take her out?
Yeah, not right now, Luke.
What old Byron have to say?
Found a shell casing in Bobby's room. 16 gauge. Says it's a real good lead.
Yeah? All right. That's good. It's about time you did something, huh?
Well, that is a beautiful necklace.
Isn't it nice? Luke bought it for me. You're such a sweet thing. It's real, 18 karat gold. And a diamond watch, too. It's Swiss. Luke's got one, too.
Well, you're just all set now, aren't you?
Who wants to make some lemonade?
Me, I do!
Oh, yeah? I bet you I beat you there.
No, you're not! No, you're not! I didn't beat you!
You have to run faster than that.
Hey, not so fast.
That 16 gauge is Luke's gun, isn't it?
Oh, but you believe Luke killed Mama, Daddy, and Bobby?
I don't know. But I think it's not impossible.
Hey, that's the craziest thing I ever heard. That test don't mean nothing. Byron went after me, now he's going after Luke. He's running around in damn circles.
Did you hear what he was saying? It was someone who knew the house, knew the gun.
I don't want to hear any more about that. That's enough.
The property is gorgeous.
I have several buyers up in Atlanta who I know will be interested in a property like this. We should have no trouble at all.
Daddy was so proud of this big house. Lots of good memories for me growing up here.
Three bedrooms, is that right?
Mm-hmm. Two little ones upstairs.
The master bath is nice and big. There's room for a jacuzzi.
Nothing's changed. I almost think it never happened.
Yet, boy. I can get a clear shot.
No, my daddy cleared this land and built this house brick by brick, all by himself. It's a family home, and I don't think I can sell it. Truth is, the thing that makes me happy is to move back in here.
You want to live here?
We could do it. I mean, we could sell the house in town. Got the office and the sheds right here. We got the woods and the fields. I mean, this is where the kids should grow up. They'd love it here.
I don't know if it's such a good thing to do.
Maybe it's the best thing to do. It's a way to face up to what's happened here. Put it all behind us.
I don't know if I can.
Well, Patty, I really think that we could be happy out here. I mean, it's what my mom and daddy would have wanted. Can we just give it a try?
What on earth would possess y'all to move in that house?
Well, it's the practical thing to do, Luke. Why don't you think about moving back in your old room?
Luke couldn't live in that house after what he saw. I'm surprised you can.
I don't even want to go in that house, let alone live there. Y'all knew that.
Luke, anyway, you got a room there anytime you want to change your mind.
Hi, Patty.
Byron.
Let me give you a hand.
Thank you.
Another gorgeous day. Sure could use some rain, though.
Byron, you didn't come find me to talk about weather.
I just went by the house, but I guess Walker's out on the run. It's been confirmed, Patty. The murder weapon was a 16-gauge from the basement. That's Luke's gun, isn't it?
I don't know. I guess he used it sometimes.
What'd Luke say when he found out we had the shell?
He didn't say much. Said it was good.
Good? What about Walker? He give any more thought to what we told him?
You're gonna have to ask him.
Isn't that Luke's stuff?
Yeah, I'm gonna send it on over to him.
Well, hold on. I've been talking to him. Maybe he's gonna change his mind.
Walker, I don't want Luke living with us. I don't even want Luke around after what I've been told.
After you've been told what? What are you talking about?
The lab confirmed it was Luke's shotgun that killed your folks.
Who told you that?
Byron.
Byron told you that? What's Byron talking to you for? That son of a...
How you guys doing? You miss your Uncle Luke?
Yeah.
Yeah? I got something for you. A housewarming gift.
Well, that's really nice, Luke. You didn't have to do that.
Hey, no problem.
Can we tell him now?
I've asked Kimberly to be my wife.
You actually want to marry this no good pea picker?
You know I do.
Well, I'm happy for y'all. Lord knows we can use some happiness in this family.
Yeah.
When's the big day?
Can we come?
Sure you can, baby doll. Planning to do it the Saturday after next.
So soon?
I don't see no reason to wait. Do you, sugar?
Walker, I'd, appreciate it if you'd be my best man.
Well, it'd be an honor. Daddy wanted you to take that money, go to college, make a better life for yourself.
I got a good life, bro. I got money. I'm marrying the most beautiful girl in the county.
Well, how much of the money from Daddy's insurance you got left now?
That's my affair.
Well, he'd have gone crazy, see how you're spending it.
Well, Daddy's not around anymore, is he?
Well, you're marrying Kimberly. Look, I'm not saying nothing against it. All right, if you're happy, Luke. But you know what Mama would have said, Kim, a Methodist and all.
Man, I swear you were sounding more and more like Daddy every day. You know that?
I mean, you're not a quarter as bad as he is yet, but you're headed in that direction. And I'm not a kid, Walker. I'm not asking for your permission.
Luke, I just want you to be happy. That's all.
Kimberly, do you think this is such a good idea so soon after the murders?
Getting married? Luke seems to think it's a good idea.
Well, I mean, with the case still open. You know they're investigating Luke.
Everybody knows that's ridiculous.
But are you sure you want to marry him before he's cleared of the crime?
Of course I am. Life has to go on. That's what Luke says, and I agree with him. I think it's a good idea.
Luke, before we go back in, I gotta talk to you about something. Byron told me you failed your polygraph test. I know it's stupid and things are all screwed up. It's that Byron. He had it out for me, now he's got it in his head, it's you, and I just want you to clear your name, all right? So he can get on looking for the real killer. Now, I checked it out. You can go to Atlanta, and they can give you a more complete test.
I don't want to go to Atlanta.
I know you don't want to go to Atlanta, but I'm going to take care of the expenses on this one.
Oh, it's a waste of time and money, and it's not going to mean a thing. I'm innocent. I don't give a damn if some sheriff don't believe that.
Do it for me, all right? We don't even got to tell Byron. Just take that test for me.
I can do it for you. It hurts me that you'd even ask. I'm not going, and that's it.
Luke, I tell you what I'm going to do. You go to Atlanta, and I'm going to sell one of the trucks and give you the cash as a wedding present, okay?
I don't give a damn about your money. What, the truck's mine anyway. Whole damn company's mine if I ever find that will.
Hey, Luke, you don't do this one thing for me, then I'm sorry. I don't think I can be your best man at your wedding.
Kimberly is anxious to get started.
He ain't coming, Aunt Claire. Said he wouldn't, and he's not.
I can't believe he'd miss his own brother's wedding. What is going on between you two?
You best ask him. He's so damn stubborn. Let's start.
Uncle Luke caught the biggest catfish in the whole pond. You know what? Yes, he did. You know what I did? I grabbed on to him. Yes, sir. And he grabbed on to me, and we grabbed on that big old tree by the pond, and we pulled that fish to the shore.
No, you didn't.
Yes, we did.
No, you don't.
And then you know what else happened? Mama cooked it up, and we fed half the county, and...
No, you didn't.
Yes, we did. Still had some for breakfast, didn't we, Mama?
No.
Okay, come on. Time for bed.
You think they're married yet?
Well, I don't know, buddy. I feel bad we couldn't go, too. Sometimes grown-ups just disagree on things.
All right, you two, come on. It's time to brush your teeth.
I want to suck your blood.
Yeah.
Good night.
Oh, you're getting big.
Walking out of here this time. But just remember something, Luke. There's two people in this world knows who killed your family. I'm looking at one, and you're looking at the other.
hell you doing?
For Daddy's will, what the hell you think I'm doing?
Hey, Luke, you want the whole company, huh? You want the trucks, you want everything? There's no will here.
I need money, Walker!
You had $200,000 and you blew it off. Stupidest thing I ever saw.
Now you're talking like Daddy again. I hate it when you do that.
Yeah, like you hated him, huh? Like you hated Mama and Bobby?
Oh, that's right. Now you're thinking about it, aren't you? You're wondering, did little Luke do it?
Did you do it, Luke?
Oh, what do you think? You think I did it?
I don't want any games, Luke.
It's just interesting to me to see the faith that my brother has in me. Sheriff's been working on Patty. Patty's been working on you.
Walker, where? You're gonna come in that house, and you're going in those bedrooms, and you're gonna show me what you saw.
No, Walker, I ain't going in that house.
I'm not going in that house, Walker.
Show me. Tell me that you didn't do it. Did you do it?
You believe it, you won't believe, big brother. Do what you gotta do.
Stop, Walker! Don't, Walker, please don't do this, Walker. Just let him go. Let him go, please.
You take two to Max. That's your half. You send Willie or someone around tomorrow. Pick them up. I'll sign the papers, they'll be on the front seat. And I don't owe you anything. I never want to see you again. You understand?
Okay.
If you come back here, Luke, I'll kill you.
How you doing?
I thought you were up in Atlanta.
Yeah, we were, but we're back now. Staying up at the Winborn place. Saved my boy. Ain't he a cute little devil?
Yeah. Luckily, he got his looks from his mama. We got to straighten something out, Luke. It's all very well talking out here in the street like this, showing off your boy, but nothing's changed. Just so you don't misunderstand.
Hey, Byron.
Patty said you might be here.
That's nice of you, Byron.
You know, my mama's over there by those trees. I even have a plot of my own. I like knowing where I'm gonna end up. I'm no rush, I understand, but my line of work, you never know. Saw a mutual acquaintance of ours in town yesterday. You know Luke's back?
Heard something about it.
He call you yet?
No, he won't.
I hear he's out of money. That's why he's come back. Sooner or later, he'll call you. I know who killed your family, Walker. Deep down, I think you do, too. Luke belongs in prison.
Nothing's gonna bring my family back.
No. But I think it's the only way your mama and daddy and Bobby can rest in peace.
No, no.
Mama.
There's Mom over here. What you so worried about? Huh?
Huh? Hi. Look what you got here.
Just a Nassau. Just for a week. Mama said she can take care of the babe.
We can't afford it, Kimberly.
Why don't we sell the truck? It's not like it's making us some big income.
I tell you, two times I screw up, they blacklist me. I'll bet you it's because my brother's been bad-mouthing me to him, you know?
Luke, when we got married, you said you owned Morrison Truck, and that's what you said. I didn't know we were going to be having money problems. Walker. Phone.
Yeah.
Come on.
Hey, how's it going?
Hello, Luke.
What do you want?
I was just thinking about you, is all. I mean, hey, we haven't even talked to each other in 2 years. Just hoping there's, you know, some way we could patch things up.
How's work? They
gave me some loads?
You know they're not.
Stafford's nothing but a horse's ass.
I heard you sold a truck. Yeah. Yeah, I had to. Other one's in tip-top shape, though. It's all ready to go. Look, Walker. Truth is, I won't come back. Work for you.
I don't know, Luke. I think about that.
Yeah, well, of course. You know, you think about it. I'll give you a call back in a couple of days. I appreciate it. Just, you tell Patty and the kids I said hi.
Okay.
What does he want?
Let's come back.
You're not gonna let him.
We've had 2 good years without him in our lives. If he comes back to work for the company, it'll be like it was before. But if you refuse him, it could be worse. Can't you just give him some money, make him go away? I don't want him back in our lives.
If I was to do this, how would it work?
Well, we'll put a mic on you. Then you invite him over for a visit. When the two of you are alone, you'll have to draw him out. Tell him you think that he was a victim. Let him know that you believe he was justified in doing what he did. Believe me, if there was any other way to find out the truth,
well, what if he catches on?
You'll have to trust us, Patty. We'll have several agents near him and a sharpshooter on him at all times.
A sharpshooter?
Well, yeah, I see it. You got 2 choices. You can settle this thing now once and for all, or you can spend the rest of your life never knowing the truth.
Now, I want you to try and face him when he talks. Don't get too far away. How's that? Comfortable?
Mm-hmm. Just try and keep him around the office, trucks, and the tool shed. He should be well covered. Now, the DA's office has only given us one shot at this, so give it your best. Oh, you expecting the governor, Patty?
Cooking calms my nerves.
Listen, the kids are at your mom's. We got Walker well covered.
I've never seen him so nervous. He could just break down and Luke could do about anything out there.
Look, he'll be fine. You just serve up one of your famous dinners. And keep Kimberly out of the way.
Byron. You just get him through this alive.
Best darn lasagna I ever eaten, too.
Thanks, Luke. I knew it was your favorite. What about mine?
What? Yours is good, honey.
Mm-hmm.
Yours is. That's
yeah.
Just, that's about as close to paradise as a man could come. You know? Hey, Walker, you hear old Jake Lomax died? It's a shame. He's a good old man.
Yeah, none better.
Didn't his granddaughter move to New York, marry that dentist? I heard she was trying to be a singer in L.A.
Actually, that was her sister, Mary Beth.
That's right. People's lives are interesting. They sure are. You know, we have a lot of pie left. Why don't y'all take some home?
Well, all right. Don't mind if I do take a slice or two.
It's gonna get dark soon.
Why don't we go take a look at that truck? See if she's in one piece.
Sure.
They're heading out. Now fall back.
Well, you know, I kept her up. Regular service. Look, you know, I feel bad about the way we fell out.
It's gonna take a minute, sugar.
I hope so.
Here, boy.
Hey, boy.
Daddy!
Well, surprise. We got a warm front passing through eastern Georgia this afternoon. Temperatures up a little on the average for this time of year. We're cooling towards...
Kimberly!
Kimberly?
What is it, baby?
They're dead.
What?
Mama and Daddy... And Bobby, someone shot him. Bobby, too.
Did you call the sheriff? I'll call the sheriff. I'll call the dispatcher and get him to call Walker and get him home.
What?
Someone take care of those dogs. There's a kennel in the back.
Kid says there's three down that he saw.
Walk around?
No. My guess is he's out on the road.
All right, let's go. Come on, boys!
George, take the back.
Let's go.
Frank, check that side.
All right, over here.
She's bound to be there now.
Walker, you copy? Walker Morrison, you copy?
Walker here, Clyde. How's it hanging, boy?
You gotta come home. There's some trouble at your parents' place.
What kind of trouble? What's going on, Clyde?
I don't know anything about it, Walker. Honest. The sheriff's there. We want you back.
Okay, you tell him I'm 3 hours away. Out.
Walker,
Luke, do you have any idea who might have done this?
No, sir.
Do you think they could come back? I mean, if somebody's killing Morrison's, maybe we're next.
I don't know.
Where's Walker at?
He's on his way. He would have killed Luke, too, if he'd been home. Who could have done this?
Daddy, he had his enemies, you know. It could have been another trucking outfit, or...
Were there any drivers your daddy had a fight with?
I don't know.
Do you ever hear anyone threaten your daddy?
Nobody who...
That'll calm you. Help you sleep.
Well, we believe they were killed the night before you found them. Now, do you remember seeing any strange cars parked out on the road?
I've been at Kimberly's. I hadn't been home in a couple of days.
Couldn't we do this in the morning, George? Come on.
Yeah, I should get back to the house. Slow down, Walker. Slow down.
What's going on,
Walker,
George?
You can't go in right
Where's
now.
Where's my mama?
You can't go in right now. I'm sorry. Walker.
Mama! Daddy!
Can't go in.
Walker, something terrible's happened. Your mom and daddy are dead. Young Bobby, too. Someone shot him.
No.
I'm real sorry, Walker.
I want to see him right now.
Not right George. Now. Look, we're gathering evidence.
What about Luke? Where's Luke?
Luke's the one who found him, Walker. He's over at your place. Why don't you go see him? He needs you.
You go to sleep now, sweet pea.
Mama, what's wrong with Uncle Luke?
Never mind that now, okay? We'll talk about it in the morning. Why don't you go climb in bed?
Okay.
Go on.
I was at Kimberly's when it happened. I came home to check in for her. I went out on my run. I just wish I could have been there, you know, because then I could.
You could have been killed yourself, Luke. I'm here now. We're gonna find out who did this. You just get some sleep. Come on. We'll talk tomorrow. Lay down. Come. You just rest.
So, looks like they must have shot Garth dead in the hallway, then continued on to Bobby's room, shot him. Then on into the parents' bedroom, they shot Flo, wounding her first. She must have tried to use the telephone. We found her bloody prints on it.
The killer, or killers, knew what they were doing. No spent shells, no fingerprints, no signs of forced entry. Nothing seems to be missing from the house, so we can rule out robbery. We need some theories, boys.
Well, you know how old Garth was. Wasn't love that built Morrison Trucking.
Yeah. I think it was someone they knew. A stranger never could have got past those dogs without waking everybody up.
Yeah, but who could have got past the dogs?
Well, a couple of neighbors, cleaning lady, Luke.
And Walker.
When do you meet him by?
Why don't you try to eat something, Luke?
It's funny.
Okay.
Just the other day, Daddy's talking about how he's gonna take us up that rodeo at Stanton.
Sure thing.
I still can't believe he's gone.
That was the funeral home. Somebody has to pick out some clothes for them all to wear.
You're more familiar with where the things are, Luke.
I can't. I don't ever want to go in that house again.
You can stay here as long as you want, right, hon?
Of course you can. You can have the room in the basement. You can have it as long as you need it. I'll get Aunt Claire to pick out some clothes.
Morning, Patty.
Morning, Byron.
Walker. How you holding up? Lousy timing on my part, but I have some questions for you.
Well, come on in, Byron.
Well, might be best if you come down to the office.
Okay, I'll get my keys.
You know what? Why don't you just ride with me? We can talk on the way.
What's going on?
It was just routine, Patty. We have a lot of blanks to fill.
I don't think my brother had anything to do with this, do you, Byron?
It's okay. I'll be back in a little while.
If you were upstate at the time of the murders, show us a gas receipt.
I already told you, Byron. I refueled up before I left.
What about a receipt from a diner?
Patty packed my meals.
You didn't check in with anyone when you picked up your load?
No. They left it for me in a lot. Why do you think I'd kill my family, Byron?
Morrison Trucking be yours. Your daddy leaned on you all your life, Walker. We all know that. We all understand why he'd want to put a stop to it.
Look at this road grind. I got dirt on my truck.
This company's going to hell in a handcart. You don't even make a decent trucker.
You know what? You do it. I'll go work for somebody else.
You know, you still ain't too big to take a hog strap to.
Yes, I am, Daddy.
You walk out of here now, that's it. You get nothing, you leave now. You go now. This is it. Nothing.
You're right. My daddy did lean on me all my life. Byron, you know what? I could take it. After I went back to working for him last year, things were good between us. He lost that mean streak, and now he's gone.
Walker! You ruined the most important day of my life.
You keep your voice down.
Everyone's coming into the church, all asking me, where's Walker? What am I supposed to tell them?
Well, Luke, you made your decision, I made mine.
They're all starting to think you're against me.
Oh, Luke, your brother's not against you.
Oh, well, someone around here is. You? You and your little friend, the sheriff? Tell me something, Patty. Do you think that it was right that my brother never came to my wedding? Sure you do. Walker can do no wrong. You know who you remind me of? Mama. You can be just like her. Bobby this and Bobby that. Mama, her sweet little Bobby. Bobby could do no wrong either. Well, let me tell you something, sis. Walker, my brother. That's a bond that's stronger than any marriage. So don't you think that you can ever come between us? You understand?
Walker, you're supposed to be the head of the family now, and instead you're tearing it apart. I'll tell you, the rumors are flying. Some say it's money. Some say you just hate the Grangers. Others have it you're in love with Kimberly yourself.
Oh, come on.
As if this family hasn't had enough tragedy. Just what is going on between you two?
You'll know what's going on. Luke failed his polygraph test, now Byron suspects him.
Of the murders?
I want him to go to Atlanta, take another test, clear his name. He won't do it, refuses.
But You must know in your heart Luke had nothing to do with it.
I want some answers, Claire.
Hey, Wilma.
Yeah?
Hey, where are Bo and Michelle?
Didn't the Uncle Luke pick them up at lunch?
Well, I thought I saw that car of his.
Took him for a ride. He loves those kids.
Byron.
Don't involve Byron.
Are you coming or not?
Patty? Patty?
How long they've been gone?
Just since noon. I'm sure everything's fine.
Yeah, they'll turn up. Best thing for you to do is go home. They might be there or they might call. George?
No, I would really like to go with you and look for him, please.
That's our job, Patty. You go home.
Yeah. Come on. He's right. Let's go.
Michelle? Oh. Walker.
It's okay. We'll find them. Be all right. Come on.
Surprise!
Surprise!
Oh. Man, we got you so good. Party car in a shed so you couldn't see it.
Where were you, Luke, and what were you doing?
We were driving around in a car, seeing the sights. Is there something wrong?
Yeah, something's wrong. What were you thinking of? You didn't realize how upset we'd be?
No, I didn't. I'm sorry, I would have had him back sooner. It's just we were having too much damn fun, weren't we, guys?
Yeah!
I don't want you around my family anymore, Luke. You understand that?
I beg your pardon?
You stay away from us.
Patty.
Hold on, Walker. You don't want me around here anymore?
No.
Well, then, that's the way it's gonna be.
Patty. Honey. Luke's my brother, and I'll deal with him, okay?
Can't you see he's dangerous? He threatens me. He takes off with the kids. What does he have to do? Kill us all?
He listened to me. My brother loved my mama and daddy and Bobby. Now, you're asking me to believe that my little brother killed my whole family? I can't do that. I'm sorry.
For a visit. Walker's gonna be gone till tomorrow morning. Thought we'd have some privacy.
I told you not to come around here.
Yeah, well, I think you and I got some things we need to talk about.
I have nothing to say to you.
Well, I do. I ain't leaving until we reach an understanding.
All right, then. I'm just gonna go inside and I'm gonna check on the kids. And then we can talk out here.
Patty, if you don't come back, we'll come in.
And tell him to get out to the Morrison place as quickly as he can. Thank you.
don't you come on over here and sit down?
What do you want to talk to me about?
You really think I killed my folks? Because if you do, that hurts me. And you think that I went in there with my shotgun and I blew them all away. Bam, bam, bam. Mama and Daddy, sweet little Bobby. And then the other day, you thought I might even hurt your kids. Me. What kind of person do you think I am? And now I can see that you're scared I might hurt you. My own sister-in-law. You're trying to turn my brother against me. Break up what's left of our family. You think I might hurt you? Well, that hurts me, Patty. When are you gonna stop hurting me? Man, what'd you have to go and do that for? Sam's such a nice little chap.
What are you doing, Luke?
Just had a little visit with my sister.
Did you invite him?
No.
Did you ask him to leave?
Yeah.
Well, that sounds like a case of harassment to me. Get in the car. You can have a little visit with me.
I ain't going anywhere with you, Byron.
Is that a fact?
Uh-huh.
You got a choice, boy. You can get in that car by the time I count to three, or you're going to be picking gravel out of your backside for the next week. One way or another, we're going to have a little chat. One, two.
All right, Byron, I'll play your little game. I'll see you soon.
Get in the car. Okay, Luke. I want you to go through it again. I've got a few more questions.
Nothing to hide. Who's he?
I'm the man with the questions.
Where is he?
Byron.
Where's my brother?
We're asking him some questions.
Well, let me talk to him, because this is going to stop right now. Coming around scaring Patty.
Yeah, she's got good reason to be scared.
I don't want to get into that again, Byron. This is family business. Just let me take him home.
First, I want you to listen to something. Come on.
All right. Again, after you turn the corner.
I told you. I saw Daddy in the hall. I went up to him. I saw he was dead.
Then I went in Bobby's room. I saw Bobby on the bed. I went up to him, but I didn't touch him. I knew he was dead.
Who's he?
FBI Special Agent Fraser. Criminal psychologist.
I hate talking about this.
Did you go into the big bedroom?
I told you, no. I turned and ran. I don't remember much then.
All right. All right, what if I told you that your prints are all over your mama's bedroom door?
Yes, so what? I lived there. I went in my mama's room all the time.
But on the day you discovered the murders, did you go into your mama's bedroom?
I don't remember. It all happened so fast.
It all happened so fast. It's not going to cut it with us, Luke. You're going to have to remember.
I want to remember. Don't you understand that?
Sit down. Did you go into your mother's room?
Yeah, maybe I went in the room.
Yeah, you'd have to. You'd have to be right beside her. I mean, you told the sheriff that you looked right into your mama's eyes. You'd have to be standing right over her.
Now you eat up all of your French toast, Bobby, honey. I made it because it's your favorite.
Hey, where's my French toast?
Your lady, you can have cornflakes.
That ain't fair.
Hey, Mom! Luke! What have you done?
You don't give a damn about me.
Luke, did you kill your mother?
No, sir, I did not. I can never kill my mama.
It's just that
I have trouble remembering is all.
I blocked it all out, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember. I was inside the room.
Did you see the name she wrote?
What name?
On the headboard. She wrote in her own blood before she died. What if I was to tell you that the name that she wrote was yours?
I guess. That's because Mama loved me best.
I think you're lying to me now.
Mama never wrote no name on any bed. You guys are grasping at straws.
That means you ain't got nothing on me, ain't that right?
Walker?
Yeah?
I need your help.
Uh-huh.
You're free to go, Walker.
There for 6 hours. A man who just lost most of his family? For someone who's supposed to know people, Byron, you sure missed on this one.
I'll be checking out your alibi, Walker. And I think it's best if another driver makes your out-of-state runs.
I'll find out who killed my family, Byron.
Looks like someone left Mama's nightlight on. Spooky, it's like someone's still in there.
You guys been inside?
No. I can't face it. We'll get someone to go in and clean up after Byron says it's all right.
You know, here's Billy Tedhauser. He had it in for Daddy.
What was that trouble?
Well, Daddy caught him switching some old tires for some new ones, and he fired him. Billy said he'd kill him. I don't think he'd have it in him.
But if they hated Garth, why kill Flo and Bobby?
So there wouldn't be any witnesses. Luke, how you doing? You got anything over there?
No. I've been looking till my head hurts. This whole thing's been really hard on Kimberly, too. I should really go see how she's doing tonight.
It'd be nice if we could all stay together as family for a while.
It's okay, Luke. Go ahead. Just don't forget you got that big fern necker load. You got to take up to Toronto on Thursday.
Can Willie take it? I don't feel up to it, man.
Well, okay. It's going to take both of us to look after things. I mean, that's what Daddy would say if he is here. Business first. You know, doesn't matter what's happened. We got to
top 300,000 this year, you know?
Yeah. That's what he'd say.
Thank you.
Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servants, Bobby Joe, Rita Florence, and William Garth.
Receive them into your mercy, into blessed rest and everlasting peace. Grant them rest eternal, O Lord, and let light perpetually shine upon them.
Are you ever going to see Grandma and Granddaddy again?
No, honey. They've gone up to heaven. They're with angels now.
We commit their bodies to the ground and their souls to the glorious company of your angels.
Down on you. What do you think she'd say?
Hey, Walker. People are saying the sheriff's checking you out. What? You a murderer, Walker?
Your beer.
Brother.
I'm sorry, Walker.
You got nothing to be sorry about, Luke. We all gotta get through this in our own way. I just don't want you to hurt yourself.
You're a good brother. You're always looking out for me. Come here.
Oh, no, no, do that, Chief.
I love you.
So, you'll each be entitled to half of the company, all of its assets, and your parents' home and property. Walker, as the eldest, you'll become the executor of the estate. That means, Luke, that he'll hold your money in trust until you come of age at 21.
What? Okay. I just don't really make all that much money from driving. Daddy always used to give me an allowance. I can't just get a little bit of that money, you know, to live on?
Well, there is something else. Your daddy had a life insurance policy. He named Luke and Bobby as beneficiaries, $200,000. Since Bobby's gone, it all goes to you, Luke.
Well, Jim, why Luke and Bobby only?
Well, it was when you had that falling out about 2 years ago and you went and drove for that other company for a while. Your daddy took your name right off his policy.
I remember that. Daddy said he's gonna take you off the will, too.
Yeah, he said he was writing up a new will, but he never submitted it to me.
Man. Well, you know how Daddy was. He's one day he's mad at you, next day he's your best friend. He's probably all just talk. Boy, 200 grand. For real. I can certainly live on that.
Yeah, we found the UPS guy that had delivered a package of flower seeds sometime between the murders and when the bodies were found.
Yeah?
He didn't see anything.
Byron, the new forensics. They found blood traces in the basement. The killer went to the basement after the murders.
Yeah? Why would he do that?
Steal something? Hide something?
Get Charlie D in here. I'll be back in an hour.
Well, where are you going, Byron?
I think I'll go fishing.
Hey, look who's here.
I wonder what he wants. Hey, Byron.
Boys.
Any news?
Nothing yet. We checked a list of names you gave us. You know, we're checking out some leads. Little like hunting rabbits. You got to eliminate every bush till you find out where that rabbit is. Sooner or later, though, we'll get a break. Right now, the polygraph man is down from Atlanta. He wants to test everyone connected with the case. I'd appreciate it if the two of you would come in.
Both of us?
Yeah, they want to do everyone.
Well, I got to service the truck for that Stevenson load up to Kansas City this afternoon. I could maybe do it sometime next week. No, this is more important. Let's cooperate. Willie can take that load. Clear our names, he can get on with this investigation. Come on.
I'll meet you down there.
Is your wife's name Patty?
Yes.
Do you have green eyes?
Yes.
Is there any information you're hiding about the murders of your parents and brother?
No. You know, I've been thinking about it, Byron. Daddy kept a lot of things from us, but he had these dealings with this Cincinnati company up in Chicago a while back. They were mafia. You know, he cut off business with them all of a sudden, and you know how stubborn Daddy can be sometimes. I get the feeling that this whole thing is a mafia hit. You know?
Whenever you're ready.
I mean, y'all should check that out.
We're ready. Just relax, Lou. This will only take a minute.
You wearing a black t-shirt?
Yes, sir.
Did you drive here today?
Yes.
Do you know who murdered your parents and brother?
No, sir, I wish I did.
Just answer yes or no.
Sorry.
How'd it go?
It's good.
Great.
It's weird, though. I mean, you get hooked up to that machine. I swear, it doesn't matter if you're innocent. You just start to feel all nervous.
Well, thanks for coming in, boys. I'll keep you informed about the investigation.
Byron, take a look at this. Here. There.
Oh, no.
Son?
Well, sir,
I believe I'm gonna have to buy this car.
Well, let me say that you have made a fine choice and that you're a lucky man. Because on this little sweetheart, I could offer you reasonable monthly payments.
Well, I was thinking, actually, that I don't really want to make monthly payments.
Well, how are you supposed to pay for this, son?
Y'all do accept cash, don't you?
I always wanted to do that.
How long has your daughter been dating Luke?
About a good 9 months by now.
It's a terrible shock to think something like this could happen. Kimmy will tell you it's almost destroyed the boy.
Do you have any suspects, Sheriff?
No one we can talk about yet, Mr. Granger. Now, on that night, Luke slept here?
Yes, that's right. He did that from time to time, down here on the couch.
Kimmy, of course, was upstairs in her room with the door closed.
Yes, but are you sure he was here all night?
You're not thinking of Luke.
Oh, ma'am, it's just routine. We have to eliminate everyone.
See, there's one thing that I don't understand. How is it you can be sure that he was here all night? You were asleep.
I got up a couple times.
He's up every 2 hours with his kidneys.
I checked on Luke every time, and the boy was on the couch.
Mr. Granger, is it possible that he might have gone out for a couple hours and you didn't know?
I'd have heard him. I'd have known. Sheriff, I had a beautiful young daughter upstairs and a healthy young buck downstairs. Believe me, I'd have known if he'd have set 1 foot off this couch. I'm telling you, the boy was here on the couch all night long.
Well, it'd be 50 minutes each way at the speed limit.
Yeah, at the speed limit. Last thing the boy'd want is for a trooper to pull him over. Mm-hmm. How long you figure in the house?
20 minutes, 15 at the least. So he'd have to be gone 2 hours. We should go back and time Granger's kidneys.
Yeah. All right.